Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. I'm excited because, well, we got this whole place to explore. Although... we should help Imowen. I forget where they said, but I think it's not in this sector of the city. Or section, rather. Now, I think in here... right, Adventurer Mart. Yeah, he's got a lot to say. Adventurer Mart. Yeah, let's check this place out. Cern's former home? Yeah. Should we know who Faerûn is?
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
All right, stand aside, evil. Don't you try anything stupid. I'm watching you as an Omnian soldier. So we maybe could get ourselves outfitted first before we help Imowen. Gareth is over here. Just mousing around to see if there's anything question markable.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Gareth says, eh? Perhaps your eyes are better than mine. Do you see any salamander dust here? No, I don't. Titmice and tarnations. I was sure I saw some here the last time. Did somebody sneeze when I wasn't looking? Grumble, grumble.
I trust always.
Eh? Away with you, vagrant. Can you not see that I am trying to decide on a purchase of utmost magnitude? Guess he won't have us find salamander dust for him. I'm all broken up about that. Look at that guy, the way he's, like, hulking around like that.
In the name of the council, I am here to keep order.
Move along. No loitering near the shopkeep. The goods are under my protection. You seem particularly dedicated. Have thieves been much of a problem? Not any longer. My guild specializes in theft reduction. There will be no opportunity for thievery here. Okay. Noted. Don't even think about trying to steal something. Okay, so here's Brelm.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Ah, but I do miss me adventuring days.
Ribald says, what adventuring days?
Me adventuring days, when I was an adventurer true, blast it. Does I have to be spilling it out for you?
I thought you were a cobbler.
Well, I does some cobbling now, sure, but before that, I were an adventurer.
Oh, and where have you been, oh mighty and experienced adventurer?
Well, if you must be knowing, I was well known in Scornabel for a time.
So you must have met Lord Francis then, or Denel Six Fingers. They both lived there last time I was in Scornabel.
No. Sometimes I really hate you, Ribald.
Okay.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
I be fresh from the sailing ship I am. Recently come from the moonshades. Arr, choppy seas it is.
Brelm, you've never been on an actual ship once in your entire life. Well, that makes sense, because he's a dwarf. Dwarves generally like being off the land, if they don't have to be.
You're going to keep opening mouth, aren't you?
By Moradin's hammer!
I've known Ribald here since... since the little adventure there in Shadowdale. Isn't that right, Ribald?
I never met you in Shadowdale, Brown. You got drunk here 4 months ago and haven't left.
Arr, don't be listening to him. What does he know?
It's just too entertaining.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Watch for thieves in the slums and docks, me friend. Me? I be not worried. Killed 3 last week, I did.
Here comes Ribald. You mean you were pickpocketed 3 times last week?
Now, I don't be telling stories about you, does I?
By Moradin's hammer!
I'm warning you, Ribald. You keep that wyvern away from me now.
Lucy wouldn't have hurt a soul, Brown.
You just mind me now. I don't like the look of it, and I don't like the smell of it. So there.
You got a wyvern?
I need a swig of some strong dwarven hail.
They'd be a huge silver sphere that they say disappeared in the slums out of nowhere, it did.
Did you even go and see it? Says Ribald.
Aye, I did. Last week. Huge thing it is, larger than life and twice as grim. No one knows how to get inside. No one's come out.
You were drunk all last week.
Well, I still went and seen it, blast it. I ain't blind.
That's not what you said after 9 pitchers of that termish whiskey you drank the day before last.
Well, I'd be allergic to termish. Besides, it has naught to do with yon sphere.
I just wonder how many things they have to say. They're... bickering is quite amusing.
By Moradin's hammer!
Alright. Ribald?
Ribald Bardaman at your service.
Oh, Ribald? Jahira says, greeting to you, good sir. I trust all is well. It is well enough, Miss Jahira. You'll not bring Harper trouble to me doorstep, good lady. Might I remind you that me days of involvement with your kin are long over? I am not here in an official capacity, suspicious one. There is no need to worry. With your kin, there always be a need to worry. But I should mind me manners. Please excuse me. Ribald Bardaman at your service. My adventurer Mart is the finest shopping in all Faerûn. Widest selection, lowest prices, and nary a fancy illustration. Just the goods, bare and plain. Yes, there are some items we're interested in. Music to me ears. There's a customer born every minute, and a rube soon after. Will it be for you today? Well, not being a rube, hopefully. Ooh, can't afford that. Brook's Fist. Or Borok's Fist. Staff of Rin. We didn't have a ninja toe before, did we? The sword of the ninja toe, is of lower quality than other Karaturan blades such as the katana. The ninja toe is short with a straight blade, making it ideal for subterfuge. The ninja toe is also more suited to fighting in close places, sometimes giving the ninja an advantage over the longer blades that the samurai use. Yeah, I might have seen it, I just don't remember. A giant hair crossbow. We don't have that much money. Sad thing. Is there anything that would be of use to us? A gem bag, thank you. A bag of holding. Are we full here? Yeah, it must be. Okay. Just for the hell of it, I'm going to look at this crossbow, because I usually don't mess with crossbows. So it's unlikely I'll be buying it. Where is it? Bullets. We need more money. That's what we need. We'll come back here and buy the place out. Giant hair crossbow. Though hard to verify, +3 also, it is claimed that the bowstring of this crossbow is made from the hair of a frost giant. Whatever the truth, the weapon is incredibly hard to draw, although it's Accuracy and subsequent damage are well worth the strain required. Strength of 15 or greater. Just one look at it. Alright, so this stuff... can go in there. And we can sell this armor. This might give us... I'm gonna sell the Sword of Chaos as well. It's just... it's a two-hander. I don't have mints using those. And that buckler. The short bow. Oh! Yeah, we have a ninja toe right here. Acorns don't fit in there. Oh, there's the genie's flask. Damon, look at this. This looks like a small, simple brass flask such as would be used to hold oil. The girl Myara believes it is, in fact, a magic bottle somehow containing the secret to Kala's power. Regardless, no amount of rubbing seems to do the trick. Yeah, see the last few episodes. Pommel Jewel of the Equalizer. Yeah. It can fit in there. It'll be safe in there for now. We need a scroll one as well. These are different ones.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Prices and nary a fancy illustration. Just the goods, bare and plain.
Good to hear it. That'll be it. Now, I'm not sure which of these Imowyn knows, so I'm just going to hold on to them. I know she knows magic missile, right? She's got to. She's got to, mister. Didn't realize she had all these gems and rings. I know I put this stuff in here just now. Okay. Well, that's a little better. Stuff for her. I think we have an oil of speed. Frost giant strength. It's like half our money. Fortress shield plus 3. Let's see. He's using a long sword plus 1 and a bastard sword plus 1. Now we have her with a medium shield, Jahira. Buckler for Yoshimo.
Dungeons or Hellspawn, I care nay a blot. All that matters is the deal. I'm always here to make money.
We've catalogs and an army of scribes to keep up with demand. 33 years in the same location. Old Ribald knows half his customers by name. I'll be here. Okay. That's a pretty sweet ring. Oh, charm person charges. Okay.
Ribald Bardeman at your service.
Small shield plus one. Yeah, I'm not completely sure. Hold on.
The Adventure Mart's the finest shopping in all of Faerûn. Widest selection, lowest prices, and nary a fancy illustration. Just the goods, bare and plain.
Well, I like illustrations. Could put up like a coloring book for me to look at or something. Alright, so this is a little much for us right now, but a small shield plus one. We should be able to swing that. Except can she still use spells like that?
Yes.
Apparently so. Is that a Wyvern actually here? Alright. Alright, so this helps her armor class and she can still cast spells. That's good, because she's the most vulnerable out of all of us. Alright. Now I know they don't like if we go in places like in that.
Faster than Tick, take a fast pause.
Okay. But they usually don't mind if we look at bookcases. We're not going to take any of those. We read them already in the first game.
Stand back for justice!
There is a wyvern here. Lucy. And someone by the name of Deirdre. Get back up here, Minsk.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Greetings, adventurer. I am Deirdre. I am a member of the Aurora's Magic Emporium and have access to her considerable collection of magical treasures. Would you be interested in taking a look at my wares? Yes. Oh wow, look at all this stuff. I can't afford any of it. There's the shield of Baldurin, the sword of Baldurin, the robe of Vecna, Sensate Amulet, Dakan's Zerth Blade. Is this a mod that put this in here? This is from Planescape Torment. This sword was the weapon of choice of the famous Githzerai, Dakan. Dakan was killed by a powerful entity while working for a creature known as the Nameless One. In my game, he lived. Wow. He You can memorize one extra first, second, third, and fourth level wizard spell. But not usable by mage, so gotta find a way around that. War cleric. I guess you gotta be one of the advanced kits to do that. That's crazy. Valor's helm. This helmet was worn by a mysterious warrior named Valor. The warrior was destroyed while helping a creature known as the Nameless One. Armor class plus one. Simulacrum once per day, lasting for 16 rounds. Wow. No, this we never had. The Plate of Baldurin. This plate was worn by the famous hero Baldurin. It is part of a set of weapons and armor that was stolen from a museum in the city of Baldur's Gate. Yeah, was that us who stole that? Charisma plus one and hit points plus four. Armor class minus one. Okay. 50. Maybe someday for Minsk? According to this, he can wear it. I might as well just... What is this stuff? Sensate Amulet. This amulet originates in the city of Sigil, where it was forged by the Society of Sensation. It was given out to the most loyal sensates to protect them when they travel the plains looking for new experiences. Plus two charisma, plus five hit points, and protection from evil. Wow. Harp of Pandemonium. Oh, Ravel's Harp. This is all plains. I gotta look at this stuff, sorry guys. Ravel's Harp of Pandemonium. Ravel was a powerful night hag that lived in the city of Sigil. Yes, it is pronounced Sigil for some reason, not Sigil. Somehow she angered the Lady of Pain, a powerful godlike figure that rules the city of Sigil. The Lady of Pain imprisoned Ravel within a magical maze where the night hag would be trapped for all time. The harp was one of the many artifacts that Ravel left behind in Sigil when she was imprisoned. Okay, so you can cast Pandemonium three times per day. Enemy must save or a spell or be tossed away from the bard as well as confused for three rounds. Wow. That's pretty cool. Oh, and now it says usable by instead of saying the following 3,000 people or classes can't use this item. Harmonium Halberd. This halberd, plus three, this halberd is a powerful weapon usually given out to the most important of our Harmonium captains. The Harmonia is a faction based out of the planar city known as Sigil. Strength, plus one, and intelligence and wisdom, minus one. Thaco, plus three. Alright, so these are all, for you guys don't know, there's another game called Planescape Torment, which is also created with the Infinity Engine, as you see here. It's a most excellent game. You can either play it or watch my Let's Play of it that I did quite a few years back. Alright, Valor's Helm I looked at. Plate of Baldurin. This is where we get out of, what do you call it? Planescape Torment stuff. Mercy Killer Ring. Back to it, yeah. The Mercy Killers are a powerful faction based out of the planar city of Sigil. This ring is given out to Mercy Killer assassins when they are sent out to punish those who have broken the laws of Sigil. Often these assassins will roam as far as the Prime Material Plane. Move silently, hide in shadows, and set traps all plus 20%. And I gotta check this out. We've seen the Sword of Baldurin. Doesn't really say anything new here that the other thing doesn't say. Magic resistance plus 10, lore plus 10. We did have that. The sword and the helm. I don't know if we had the shield ever. I don't think so. And Robe of Vecna. Really? This robe doesn't even have close to the power that the two famous artifacts, the Hand and Eye of Vecna, possessed. Still, from simply being worn by the powerful Lich, the robe absorbed enough magical energies to become a potent magical item. Armor class 5, magic resistance plus 10%, improves casting speed by 4. That's pretty freaking awesome. Wish we could afford it, but we'll be back. Alright, we're gonna go talk to this wyvern, or should we just look at the books over here? We'll be with the wyvern in a second. See if there's anything new. History of Shadowdales. I've read them all. More Shadowdales. There's more bookcases over there. Oh. Another painting of a party of young adventurers from long ago. This one, a diminutive barbarian. Rumor has it that this barbarian had a pet unicorn smaller than he, also swallowed by Tiamat, is presumed. Well, I never. What about this one? This is a painting of one of a group of young adventurers from long ago. This one, a ranger, all of whom were attempting to return to their homeland far away. Word has it they died horribly at the hand of the dragon Tiamat. Mm-hmm. Oh, there's a lady youth over there. Somewhat haughtily, Lucy turns away as you approach. The wyvern ignores you. I consider wyverns ignoring to be a plus. Yeah, let's go take a look at these other books. Sembia and some Shadowdales. Estigund, Gundagol, Lost King, Haurua, Lurin. I have read them all. Any other question marks? Pardon me, my lady. History of Am, Kalimshan, Cormyr, Dambrath, and Durpar and Var. The Golden. Alright, let's talk to her.
Is it important, peasant?
I beg your pardon. Hello there. I've been watching you since you entered. I suspect you may have need of my wares. What is it that you sell? Magical scrolls. Illegal, of course, which is why I must charge so much for them. Have you no fear of the cowled wizards? Those pompous fools, they are as corrupt as anyone else in this city, if you know who to talk to. Now, are you interested or not? Perhaps you could tell me whom to talk to amongst the cowled wizards, then. I'd be interested in that. Aye, I'd imagine you would be. One of the wizards by the name of Corneal decides who gets the license to use magic here. Bring plenty of coin if you go see him. That we don't have at the moment. You can probably find him in the government building in the government district. Now, would you like to see what I have to offer or not? Sure, let me see what you have. Good, take your time. Magic is not something that should be rushed. They're expensive and I do not have good money. At some point I have to go through what we all have. Oh, scroll case, thank you. It looks different though, I like it. I can pick it out easier. Worth it just for the scroll case. Minsk is empty. Now all we're missing is our potions bag. And then we'll be back in business once again. A nobleman!
My time is quick, so be brief, commoner.
This is such a large place. How will I ever find what I'm looking for? I missed the part where that's my problem. Jeez, huh? We didn't do too much, did we?
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
That's a leopard. All right, let's check up here. Mahir.
You'll find no better prices in Arm. I guarantee it.
Aha! Mahir thinks you are just the sort of customer he was waiting for. Perhaps you're interested in weaponry? Mahir thinks you are. I take it that you are Mahir? Indeed I am. Mahir in Kadar El Sadith. Most recently a Rashomon. At your service. Min says, you are coming from Rashomon? I remember it fondly, and hope to take Boo to see it once I have completed my Dajema. Aha! Boo is your witch then, I take it? No, Boo is my hamster, and Boo is my friend. Oh, I see. Where was I? Oh, yes, my lord. You are is still interested in examining my wares, yes? Yeah, show me what you have. Most excellent. Examine my wares to your heart's content, Kasadi, and I'm sure you will find nothing to displease you. How dare you call me that? I will slay you endlessly. A poison throwing dagger. Interesting. Sling plus one. Okay. Could one of us... I think one of us could use a sling plus one and maybe some bullets as well. Hold on 1 second. He's just got a regular sling. And I've got a sling plus three. And she's got a regular sling, so let's get a couple slings then.
Have a look at my wares. I trust you'll find them all in satisfactory condition.
Mahir welcomes to his shop once again. You're interested in perusing his stock of weaponcraft, yes? Mahir has all kinds to offer. Scimitars, swords, even iron weapons from the Stormhorn Mountains. Look at my wares for yourself. Do you make any special weapons? Mahir does not possess the craft to create weapons himself. There's a fine dwarven smith in this city who knows such skills. The stout one's name be Cromwell, my lord, and his shop is within the docks district here in the city. I will tell you one thing, my lord. I can create the finest of musical horns. The dwarf knows not this art. But enough of my meanderings, yes? Perhaps you would like to look at Mahir's stock of weapons now? Yes, yes. A sling plus one is pretty cheap. Surprisingly. I'll take two. All right. Mints can sell these slings if they can be sold for anything.
Well, you look like the sort who has more than two gold pieces to rub together.
Well, I can't even sell them. All right, never mind then. We'll put them somewhere later. Myrtlin?
Is this the way you talk to everyone, or is it just the poor people?
You! Have you been cheated here? I bet you have. Yoshimo says, me? Actually, I can't even remember the last time someone cheated me out of anything. What's that all about?
Is this the way you talk to everyone, or is it just the poor people?
Nobody cheats Minsk. If someone dares to cheat me, they are in for a boot-stomping adjustment to their moral value systems. Minsk gets all the best lines. Omnian Bodyguard.
In the name of the Council, I am here to keep order.
Mr. Quartaris is the art collector, not I. Speak to him. Art collector.
My time is quick, so be brief, commoner.
Good business to you, my lord. My name is Quartaris. Might you be interested in some artwork? A painting to add style to your abode? I don't think so. Nothing here really suits my taste. Well, I am afraid that I am only a purveyor of fine works of art. If you are not a customer of refinement and wealth, then you have no interest in being here, I am sure. Good business to you. Oh. I'll take that. takes care of that.
My wings have been clipped. Oh, I wish you could understand how it feels to be bound to the ground, chained and weighted like a miserable prisoner of Earth.
I have been feeling bad about that. I can't imagine what it would be like to be able to fly and then lose that. What was it like to fly, Airy? Oh, it's so hard to describe. It's the ultimate freedom to soar above the clouds and become part of the wind itself. I remember I used to be so happy. The clouds are a special place up there, Sapphire. It's like a land of billowing white beauty that you can almost walk upon. Wow. We get in trouble if we look in this box. It's empty. You know what?
Minsk and Boo, make way, villainy. Hero coming through.
Put the worthless slings in there. I'm sure that's not kosher. That may or may not be. The glory of Om nearby and stuff.
Every hamster has his day.
I trust you are here in good faith.
All of a sudden, this priest of Talos is here. Beware the streets at night, my children. There are strange things taking from the coffers of your lives. Best invest in a day to be certain of many returns. That's one way of putting it. Are you trying to warn people? Of what? Of the darkness that threatens the trade of day, as the takers of coin face blood letters foul. Walk not the streets beyond the last call of day. Sounds more like dogma than a coherent warning. Speak plain your concerns. I speak the words of the spirit, in the form that I must. If it does not prove plain enough, the listener must examine their faith. That said, I don't suppose there is much harm in stating plainly that walking the streets at night are a danger. Well, that's all you have to say. That seems quite like common sense to me. Is there more to it than the obvious? It would seem to be a war between dark and darker, one that I am hesitant to say who should win. I know a little more about this. I am not of much help, but if a single person quickens their step because of my word of warning, then I have done well. Safe travels, friend. Alright, off with you. Alright, I am going to just check around this area first before we go to the government district. Get our bearings. I'm a little curious about this place, but we do need to go help her. And, to be able to cast magic, at least in defense, would be a good thing. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.